Hola amigas, ¿cómo están? Mi nombre es Edith de la Flor de creationsbyedith.com. Si no me conocen, ¿ok? Hoy voy a estarles mostrando cómo hacer este lindo cochecito de bebé. My name is Edith de la Flor from creationsbyedith.com. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make this beautiful baby carriage with the baby in it. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make the carriage. Okay, so we're gonna start now. I see you in a little bit. Now, what I'm going to do right now is show you all the tools that you need to make this little carriage, okay? Te voy a enseñar ahora las herramientas que necesitas para hacer este lindo carruaje o coche de bebé. Okay, veamos. Ojalá que se vea. Esto es un juego de cortadores. Si yo tengo, lógicamente ustedes pueden comprar o cortarlo o ustedes mismos, ¿verdad? Son cuatro piezas. This is a set that I have. Of course, you can make your own by cutting it with a little knife. But this is what I have, okay? This is the set to make the carriage, okay? We're gonna need this. We're gonna need a rolling pin, of course. I have two different kinds of texture rolling pins. Vamos a necesitar un rodillo plano, como el que le mostré. Y acá tengo dos rodillos de diferentes texturas. Van a ver ahora por qué tengo dos. Okay. Vamos a necesitar una cuchilla acrílica. We're gonna need this acrylic knife. Or any other, you know, tool that you have similar to this one, o cualquiera que necesites que tengas, y un stick ranurador, and a, you know, a frilling stick, anyone that you have. I mean, it's fine. I have this little fine one. Yo tengo este bien finito. Some glue, of course. Just any white glue. I'm making it out of cold porcelain. Yo lo estoy haciendo de la porcelana fría, así que estoy usando pegamento blanco. Ustedes pueden hacerlo en azúcar, lógicamente, y van a usar pegamento comestible. I'm making it out of cold porcelain, so that's why I'm using the white glue. But if you want, I mean, you can make it out of sugar paste or gum paste and use edible glue instead, right? Okay, this is the paste that I'm going to use. I'm going to use the blue and white. Of course, you can make them out of any other color. Lo pueden hacer lógicamente de cualquier otro color. Yo escogí esta vez azulito y blanco. ¿Ok? Empezamos. Vamos a empezar primero, antes que nada, vamos a empezar a hacer lo que vendrían siendo las rueditas. I'm going to start by making the little wheels. Always, always. Work your paste. Siempre, siempre trabaja en la masa. And with a rolling pin, stretch your paste. Not too thin though. It has to be a little bit thick. No muy delgadito porque son rueditas. Tiene que ser un poquito anchito, gruesito. And we're gonna use this little piece. Okay? And make four. For the four wheels. Four. And put them aside to dry. It's good, I mean, the hotter they are, the better is, I mean, it's gonna hold the little carriage. Okay? I'm gonna put it aside. Mientras lo dejamos a secar un poco, porque mientras más duro esté, mejor este va a aguantarnos el cochecito. Okay, now we're gonna go with the blue paste. Ahora vamos a ir con la masa celeste. Okay. Always work your paste before you roll it. Siempre trabajen siempre su masa antes de estirarla. Okay. Si me espera un segundo, voy a coger un almohadón porque esta silla está muy bajita. Just one second, I'm gonna get a cushion. Because this chair is too low. All right. Now I'm better. All right. Now, of course, everybody knows how to roll the paste. Roll it. It's better if you make it a little bit thicker. We have to get two pieces. Okay, this is thick enough, all right? Why? Está suficiente grueso porque now we're gonna use the texture rolling pin and we're gonna press it to get the design. Ahora vamos a imprimirlo para coger el diseño. Press it firmly, presione firmemente, so we can get the design, see? Now, we cut two pieces. Let's look for the best part of the impression. Vamos a buscar la mejor manera de imprimirlo. Now, what I do is flip the paste over and cut the other piece. Okay? Now, ¿vieron lo que hice? Volteé la masa y corté del otro lado. ¿Por qué? Porque ahora vamos a tener dos piezas con impresión, una a cada lado del otro. See? Now we have the same impression on each side. Okay? Put them aside and we're going to make the other piece, which is going to be the back of the carriage. Ahora vamos a cortar, estirar masa para formar la parte de atrás del coche. Try to make it a little bit thicker. It looks better on this kind of project. Okay, we use the same rolling pin, the texture rolling pin, and just do the same. Press it firmly like that. See, and it gets a nice impression. Now, cut this piece. Cortamos ahora con esta pieza. And put the extra paste into the plastic wrap so it doesn't dry up. And all right, now what we do now, get the other two pieces, okay, like this, like that. And what we're going to do is, let me see. Glue. Hold on. One second. Okay. Now we're gonna put some glue around the edges. Vamos a poner pegamento. Un segundito que se me secó. Vamos a poner pegamento alrededor de todo el contorno, just a little bit, not too much. If you're using a gum paste, of course you're gonna use the edible glue, right? And we start from one of the edges and go around it like that. And go around. I like it when I do it this way. It's better so you can see what you're doing. Like that. Go around it. Like that. You have to be patient. Because sometimes it doesn't want to go with you. Tienes que ser paciente porque a veces no quiere hacer lo que tú quieres que haga, pero es solamente masa, no va a poder contigo. Of course, it's just paste. Okay, let's go around. Así. Lo ponemos así y presionamos. And we press. Not too hard, just to make it glue. I mean, glue the two pieces together. Just like that. Okay? And now we do the same thing with the other piece. Just a little bit of glue. Ay, ay, ay. Just a little bit of glue. I always have some baby wipes with me so I can wipe my hands. And we do the same thing. Start with the top part and put it together. Like this. There we go. Okay. So we have this little carriage. Okay. Let them dry the pieces together for a little bit. You have to be patient. We always need to let all the pieces dry before we go to the next step. If you're making a lot of them, I mean, you can start cutting all the pieces together. I mean, all the pieces, all the side pieces, and then all the pieces first, and then let them dry a little bit, and then you put everything together. Si estamos haciendo varios de estos, lo que podemos hacer es cortar todas las pinzas primera, dejarlas orear un poquito, y luego empezamos a ensamblar cada una de las piezas, ¿okay? So, le tiene que quedar algo así. ¿Okay? Dejamos a un ladito para que se sequen un segundo. ¿Okay? Déjame sacar esto que tengo acá. ¿Okay? Now, ahora vamos a usar las rueditas. ¿Okay? What I'm doing for this, you can do it both ways. You can cut the little heart. Like I'm going to show you one that I made before. I cut this on this side piece. I cut the little heart from here and placed it on the little wheels. So lo que hice en este, por ejemplo, corté el corazón, la piecita de corazón la corté en este costado y se lo pegué en las rueditas. En este, pues, no lo he hecho así. Lo que voy a hacer es poner los corazoncitos aparte. Esta sí tiene que ser fino, no tiene que ser grueso. For this, I mean, you can make it very thin. Doesn't have to be thick. So, I cut the four little hearts. Right? And glue them to the little wheels. Let's see what's right. Like that. And the center. Just a tiny, tiny bit of glue. Solo un poquitito, poquitito de pegamento. Okay. Y lo pegamos en el centro. Centered. Déjeme centrarlo bien. Okay. all these items, you can find them in my website. All the tools, the cutters. And also, I'll be making some videos for sale that you can download them from my website into your computer, so you don't have to wait for the CDs or DVDs to come to your house. This is going to be something that is going to be available soon. Voy a estar teniendo algunos videos que van a poder desde la página web bajarlos a sus computadoras, y que no van a poder, no van a tener que esperar a que llegue por correo los DVDs. Okay, now what we're going to do, we're going to place them on each side, just a little bit of blue, and place the little wheels on each side like that. And now we do the same thing. Stop. Okay. And do the same thing on the other side, and make sure that you place them exactly on the same a la misma altura que el otro. Like that. Okay, like that. I think it needs a little bit more glue on this side. Okay. The same height. Now what I do is I get a little piece of styrofoam and place it on the bottom. This way it dries, even, and it dries like that. See, like that. Let them dry like that. Make sure that they're even before you do that. Yeah, this is not even, see? This needs to be a little lower. Yeah, no, it's not even either. Yeah, as I told you, you have to be very patient. Once you do a couple, it's easier, because the first one is always, you have to make sure that they're even, and then the following, the next one, stop. See, this is something that you have to deal with. Ven? Es algo que con el que tienen que trabajar. Ah, there you go. Now they're even. Now you let them dry like this. Okay? Okay. We're fine now. Now what we're going to do, I have another piece here, styrofoam piece, that we have to make it fit into the little carriage. ¿Ves? Tengo una pieza de ternopor que lo he cortado, y vamos a hacer lo que entre en el cochecito. Entonces, esta pieza está bien. Muy bien. I'm gonna cut it a little bit here. Now it looks better. Okay, I don't know if you can see it. Looks better. And what I do, I don't like it to show it like, to show it like this, right? So I'm gonna cover it with some paste, white paste, para que no se vea el ternopor así tan feo. Lo que voy a hacer, lo voy a cubrir con un pedacito, con un poco de masa. Para esto, lógicamente, nuevamente, vamos a estirar la masa. Puede ser finita. Okay? It doesn't have to be thick at all, because it's just to cover the styrofoam. So what we do is put some glue on top of the styrofoam and cover it just like that. I mean, it doesn't have to be fancy or anything because it's not going to show. No tiene que estar bien prolijo, bien arregladito, porque es que esta parte aquí ni se va a notar. And cut the excess. This is not going to show anyways. Okay, like this. And now we glue it into the little carriage. Ahora sí lo pegamos al cochecito. Okay, like this. Make it into like that. Can you see it? Alright. Good. Oh, I love that song. Okay, now I'm going to make a little pillow for the baby. Ahora vamos a hacer una almohadita para el bebé. Okay? Make a little ball. I think this is too small. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. Pienso que es muy pequeña. Vamos a hacerlo un poquito más grande. Make it into a little ball. And put this aside. Okay? And press it. Let me clean this. Press it. And then we're going to make it make it like a little rectangle. Make a little pillow. Press it down like this. So it makes a little rectangle. Like that. I don't know if you can hear the music, but I love this song. Where's my knife? So we're gonna make some like that indentations, like when the baby's sleeping, makes the little pleats. Así, unos cortecitos para que parezcan como que el bebé ha dormido y está ahí. And then with the one of these tools, oops, just press it a little bit because the head is gonna be here. Apresionamos un poquito así porque ahí va a estar la cabecita del bebé. Okay, and we glue it into the carriage like that. Hope you can see it. Good. Okay, now we're gonna make the ruffle. This is just want to make sure that this is straight, the wheels are straight. Okay, I'm gonna make the ruffles in white. Okay, get some paste. And make a ball. Always start every work that you make, it has to start with a little ball. Okay. Estiramos la masa. Same thing, if you're gonna make it out of gum paste, you do the same thing. This is too long. We don't need it that long, right? It came out this long. Okay? You don't need it to be this long. Okay. All right. We're gonna cut it. And then we're gonna make it straight. Cut a straight line. Okay. And you can make it as wide as you want, but I think for me, I think this is enough. This is too long anyways, but that's okay. We can always cut it later. Okay. Now, what I'm going to use is my friller. I have this one, it's very thin. mine this it broke a little bit because I've been using it for a long, long time. So what happens is I stepped on it and I had something else on my shoe heels, and it broke one piece. I have more, but for some reason I still use the same one. Okay, el mío se rompió un poquito porque lo pisé con mi taco un día que no me di cuenta y le rompió un pedacito, pero por alguna razón, teniendo otros, me mantengo usando este mismo. Okay, bueno. Don't ask me why I keep using if I have more downstairs, but I do. All right, so we're going to frill the edges, one of the edges. So we just go, let me make sure that I'm not using the part that is broken. Okay, just go back and forth like that. See, it makes like little ruffles. See, van para adelante y para atrás y forman las onditas. Así de fácil. Sí. It would have been nicer if I used the other one, a new one, but it's okay. I can still use this one. Me quedaría mejor si uso uno nuevo que no esté roto, pero con estas todavía puedo seguir usándola. Ok, están viendo qué fácil es esto, ¿no es cierto? Ajá, like that. Ok, it makes little ruffles like that. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah. Ok, I'm going to use the center, and in the center I'm going to fold it and then fold it again like this. Okay, and then I'm gonna fold it on this side, and one more fold and another fold. Lo doblé en el centro, doble, y luego le hice otros dobleces aquí a los costados. Lo doblo para un lado, lo doblo para otro lado, y ahí, que va a ser mucho, pero ya veremos. Entonces va a quedar así. Trato de afinar, try to thin the edges, and this is too long, but it's okay. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to glue at the end of the carriage, all around it. Can you see? I glued it all on top, inside. Okay? Can you see? Like that. And now I'm going to place it. I'm going to cut this because it's too long, but well, I should. Okay. Start from the center. So we have to center the ruffle, go on the sides, yeah, let me cut the sides. Oh, where's my, and this is gonna be enough here, right there, and here, it's gonna be enough, and glue the inside. That's even too long. There. And do the same thing on the other side. Y hacen lo mismo. Está muy largo, vamos a cortar un poquito más. Ahí. ¿Vieron? And pull it back. y lo tiran para atrás. Así. Ajá, like that. ¿Sí? Hope you can see them. Good. Like that. Like that. Okay. Now we have now the now I have a little baby already made. One of these days I'm going to help teach you how to make it, but for this time I'm showing you only how to make the carriage. Okay, tengo este bebito ya hecho. Uno de estos días voy a enseñarles cómo hacer bebitos también. Pero para este video solamente estoy mostrándoles cómo hacer el cochecito. Okay, I didn't make the bottom part of the baby, the legs, because it's not going to show. So I'm going to place it here. Okay, I'm going to glue it. Very soon also I'm going to be having the molds of the babies, the faces and the, you know, the body and all that. So this is hard enough, it holds. See, I don't need the support anymore. So place the baby right there. Okay, now we're going to make the little the colcha. And I'm going to make it in white. The little blanket, I'm going to make it in white. So for the blanket, I'm going to use the white paste. Voy a hacer la colchita ahora con masa blanca. And ay, so you can see it. Always work your paste. Okay. Oh, it's a beautiful day today. It's sunny. Okay. If you need, you can use some oops, that's too much. Little cornstarch. That was too much, but it's okay. And roll the paste. Like that. Estiran la masa. Not too thick, not too thin. No muy gruesa, no muy delgada. Okay, it's okay because I'm going to cut this part. And now I'm going to use the other texture rolling pin, because this, I think this for blanket, it looks a lot more, nicer. Okay, voy a usar este rolling pin, este rodillito. Pues me gusta el diseño, que para colchita de bebé se ve muy, muy bonita. Okay, y presiono. Se ve delicada. And press it. And that's it. Alright. So now I'm going to cut like a square. Square. If you want, you can frill the edges also. It looks nicer, a lot nicer, very finished. Pueden usar el ranurador para afinar los bordes de toda la colcha, que lo hace ver más fino todo alrededor. Okay. I like these details. I mean, every detail that you put into the piece, it makes it a very complete, very nice. I mean, you took your time to do something nice, so it's better if you go the extra step to make it look nicer. Siempre es bueno ir un paso más ahí adelante para que se vea un trabajo bien acabado, que se cogió su tiempo de hacer algo bien hecho. So And this is fast to do. I mean, this is very fast. It doesn't take that much time to make. No coge mucho tiempo. Y va a ver que se va a ver un acabado más bonito. ¿Ven? Así. Okay. See, it looks nicer. And fold it. And fold it again. And then place it on top of the baby. Always with some movement. Make it... I want the arms to show. Like this. Yeah. Put some movement into the piece. Like this. Let the arms show a little bit. And that's it. Okay? And the piece is complete. Okay? It's all done. I hope you have fun watching it, and I hope you make them. Make a lot. I mean, you can make a lot of them for favors, as a cake topper. I mean, mini cakes. Puedes hacer muchísimas cosas con él. Este cochecito puede usar como un adorno de torta, como un adorno para mini torta, como souvenir, como favors para cualquier baby shower, un bautizo, primer añito, qué sé yo. La idea está aquí y está en ustedes que la usen de la manera que más les convenga, ¿ok? Espero que les haya gustado. Y los veo en el próximo proyecto. ¿Ok? Bye. No se olviden de visitar mi página web y ver los nuevos videos que voy a tener disponibles próximamente. De muchos trabajos de modelado. De bebé. De los muñequitos. De los animes. I'm going to be making a lot of videos. For baby showers. Anime. That are right now in style. And don't forget to look at my website, and I see you at the next video. Bye bye. Los veo.